free goods, like it's an offering which we do with the relation to the main item. Like that's called the free goods, and we, in the free goods in SAP we have two things. One is inclusive and one is exclusive. Okay. So suppose first we'll talk, we'll make a line here. Even my line is not straight. What I draw. No. Okay, I'll write it simply. It's an inclusive first. And one another is exclusive. Okay. Say, suppose, I'll just give an example of what is inclusive and exclusive. Suppose, say, the order quantity. Order quantity is 300. Okay. So if it comes to inclusive, how it is this? If I order 10 material, if this is X material, material X, quantity is 300 actually. If I order X material of 240, okay. Suppose say if I ordered 300, but if it is inclusive, what it do is it will take main item as 240 and sub item, that is free goods, that is 60. That is, free goods is included within the order quantity. So we deliver customer 300, but customer need to pay only for 240 quantity. The rest 60 is free. This is inclusive within the ordered quantity. Okay. Suppose say if it is exclusive, I ordered 10. This is order number 10. X material 300. If I offer free goods for this, it would be like this. Like say 10. I offer 60 material as free. That is, this is exclusive from the ordered quantity. You got it right? It is here we deliver 360, here we deliver 300. Here customer has to pay for 300, here customer has to pay for 240. So this is inclusive and exclusive. And yeah, it's exclusive. If it's inclusive, customer, company won't get any benefit. If it is exclusive, at least they can push more products into the market. So, and in inclusive, we can offer only same material as a free goods. As we see here, in this example, see, customer ordered 300, then what we done, we have offered X material. Okay, and we are giving free goods also X, because it's the same material and we are making as a 300 quantity. If client's requirement is 300 quantity for this X material, we cannot deliver 240 as X material and Y material another 60.
Okay.
So inclusive, always we can offer the same material as a free goods, no other material. Okay, if he is offering, he is ordering 300 laptops, I need to give him 240 plus 60 other laptops. But I cannot give him 240 laptops plus 60 external hard drives or 60 headsets or something. His requirement is for 300 laptops. In the same way, in exclusive, we can offer anything as free goods. That is any other material than this material. For 300 laptops, I can offer 60 external hard drives or headsets or any other accessories. So in exclusive, we have an option of offering other material as a free goods. Okay. And in inclusive, we have another two things. One is with item generation and without item generation. Okay. So suppose with item generation, if customer is ordering the same 300, will take above example 300 quantity X material. If he is ordering 240, we'll give 60 as free goods. Okay, and this 60 will become R100 condition will determine, and it will make the 60 as free goods. That means the discount is within the ordered quantity, inclusive within the item generation. Okay. And if it is inclusive without item generation, what we will do is we will deliver 300 quantity, and we will charge for 300. We will charge only for 240,000. That is 60 goods is free here. Okay. Here no line item, but in the both cases we deliver 300 quantity. Okay, so in inclusive with item generation, the free goods item will be determined as a separate line item. Here we have a separate line item. Okay, but here, like without item generation, free goods will not be determined as a separate line item. It will be included within the ordered quantity. Okay, so here, yeah, that's what. See here, it will be determined with R100 condition. This will come and make this 60 quantity as zero value. Here, NRIB condition type will be determined. We have just discussed NRIB condition requirement 59. So what this will do is, this will deduct the 60 quantity value from the main 300 quantity value. Suppose it is 3 lakhs. It will make the total as 2,40,000. That means it is discounting 60 goods value here. Okay. So this is the little difference between these two, inclusive and yeah. Yes, it will only show as a discount, nothing. It will only show the value of discounted amount. It's not a special discount, but it's a practice where business follows actually. Sometimes they would be giving the free goods within the ordered quantity. Sometimes they give free goods apart from the ordered quantity. Okay, but for both of these, it use the item category TAM. Okay, so what in general TAM it checks, the pricing should be B. R100 condition always checks that in TAN item category the pricing field should be always B. Okay, so how this checks? With the help of the requirement 55, which we maintain in the pricing procedure. Okay, so we have this free goods, actually we can offer manually or we can automate it. Like we have item category determination or item category group norm and higher level item usage and higher level item. If I maintain usage free in CMIR, then this would be automated free goods. Okay. So if you want to maintain manually, we will just enter into the sales document, that's it. No. This will determine TANN. If it is free and higher level it is TAN, then it will automatically determine TANN. Okay. So and the R1 condition type is always placed in pricing procedure after the net value. Why? Because we give discount on the net value. Okay, and there is a formula also for this. We'll just check base type formula 28. You see this 28th formula?
Yeah.
100% discount. So for R1 and R100 condition, what we will do is we will maintain requirement as 55 and we will maintain base type formula as 28. So this is already, this formula is predefined from the system. And for NRIB condition, we will maintain 59 as the requirement and we will maintain 29. You see 29 free goods, but it's inclusive, that is NRIB. Okay, so this is what checks actually system to propose the free goods. Okay, and into free goods, like I mentioned the configuration and this all things in the document. Let me show. So I have given a very clear table with example and everything here. What is the difference between the inclusive and exclusive? And again, inclusive is classified into with item generation and without item generation. And here R1 condition type will be determined. And here NRIB condition type will be determined. Everything is same, and the configuration of free goods and the manual and the automatic free goods, how it works. You see this item usage. Thank you.
So this is, I have mentioned everything here, and you see the formulas here. 59 the requirement, and you see the formula base type 29.
Okay.
So this is what we maintain for NRIB condition type and R100 condition type. And remember, always these free goods condition types are placed after the net value.
Okay.
That's one thing. And see, the main thing we find what it is I want to transfer the cost of the free goods to the main item.
NRIB condition, like I will show with an example here very clearly. And there is a configuration also for this that's already mentioned in the document. Say suppose I have an X material of 100 quantity. Okay, and I have free goods, that is Y material of 20 quantity. Okay, so if it is into 1000, okay, it comes up 1 lakh. Okay, and the free goods, it is 20,000, right? But see, I am saying this as 20,000, but it need not, my cost price may not be this price, right? This is my selling price actually. Okay, but I want to like set the transfer of cost to the main item, cost of these free goods into the main item, so that for my reporting purpose it will help. If I transfer the cost price of free goods itself as it is into the this document, it will show as 1,20,000. And in reporting I may not find the difference. Okay, so I want to know the actual price of this document, this goods. Suppose say I can get this for only 700. My cost price of this item is 700, but my selling price is 1000. So if I transfer 700 into this, my report will show accurate for the management, right? So if I want to transfer this cost price to the main item, there is a small setting we need to do in copy controls. Okay, so what, look, I have mentioned this here. There is, you remember there is a field cumulate cost in copy controls, in billing document to delivery document type. See, if you want to, there is a path also for this. You need to set transfer of cost to main item. You need to click this. Okay, so in this, like this configuration, this will help to transfer the cost from free goods main item. And there what we need to do is we need to select the F2 and L2, this billing type and the delivery type, and we need to take the position of TAN, that is free goods item category, and there we will find accumulate cost field. There is an indicator there. Yes. VT. VTFL. FL. This is. Yeah, I'll go and show you if not. This is an important thing which generally you face in the interview, not in the real time. But because they will be asking you to transfer this. VTFL. I don't know, but why copy controls take lot of time to open in my system or any other system? It's the same in your system? Okay. So we'll go to item. TANN. No, this billing type is F2 and delivery type is LF. So I'll select and click on item. You see this field, cumulative cost? This is the field. I'll just F1 it. You can further read it. You see this, like it says, like this field is used to main in the main item control, where the cost value, usually candidate VPRS, is to be copied from the relevant sub item. Sub item in the sense, it's a free goods item. The following cases we use this, actually it's in free goods, batch split and bill of material BOM. Okay, so whenever if you want to accumulate the cost of components and send transfer that to the main item, then we use this cumulate cost. Okay, and this you would be quite often you will see this in your real time requirements. Okay, from where you want to get that price? This is mostly used in the shipping cost document. Price source NRA is that. Price source from purchase order actually here, and F is shipment cost. See, in third party sometimes we maintain A. That means whatever the price mentioned in purchase order, we need to copy that from the purchase order. So that is a source to copy that, and F is for shipment cost. So this is maintained where, like in billing, we want that pricing to be taken from the shipment cost document. So we specify here the price source is F. What is it? F. Somewhere we'll use N also. N it is not here, but somewhere it is, like I guess it's in shipping documents. Yeah, we already discussed that this will have a relationship with the item category field. When we discussed the item categories, what is the field in item category? Indicates whether during copying the quantity or value in target document has a negative effect or positive effect. You remember we discussed this there in item categories. It's open somewhere in this item category. Yeah. You see this billing quantity, which we see in third party. We maintain E and G. Delivery quantity less invoice quantity, not this we use. We use this one, goods received quantity less invoice quantity. and invoice receipt quantity less invoice quantity. These two actually we use in third party, E and F.
Right.
And just F1 on that. You see, what is the quantity to be copied from the source document? So in third party we use generally, you see this E and F, third party transactions. We will either take it from the MyGo or Myro. And you remember this VBRK, VBRP field. If you want to restrict the line items in an invoice, we just seen a configuration, assign, go to the country specific. There. Just F4. Look, we have seen that, suppose say if you want to restrict the line items in a document, okay, invoice split, I don't remember what exactly the number used for, but actually even we maintain it here. Or what this helps is like say whether to have only a single invoice or you can have multiple invoice, 9 or something. 8, 9 is not the total invoice, not China. Invoice split 7. We can split invoice, single invoice, intercompany billing. Yeah. Not during the transfer of data from billing document item fields during copying. Checks the requirement. It's just a routine. Like say suppose say when copying the value, suppose say we say here a single invoice. If I maintain this 003, that means system will not allow to create multiple invoice. Okay. So we will discuss this in copy controls very clear with some example also. So coming back to the free goods, like this is one important thing which we need to know, that cumulative cost. You remember this price type?
Yes.
A, B, C, D, price type, carry price, components, and redetermine taxes, new pricing, manual, don't read. Yeah. Yes. In item category. Yeah, condition. It is in V/06 actually, condition type. Condition calculation type, this field. This field will have relationship to the price type in copy controls, what just we have seen. Okay. Where? In the order in the bottom we will have. Right, the button. It's price update. It's not price type, it's price update. So yeah, it's pricing type. It is more or less like suppose say if you want to change the price in the document itself, there itself, then you go through the price update. So the important things we need to know in the free goods is the controls. Again, free goods also have some controls. Condition VBN1 discount type NA00. I'll just take standard NA00 or something. It's yeah. and standard. See, these are the important fields what we need to see here. See, I'll just explain you the controls. This is nothing but material what we enter. Okay. And this one your description. See, this is minimum quantity. Okay, that means it is a quantity which customer has to place order to be eligible for the free goods. That means if I place 100 here and customer orders for 99, he will not be eligible for discount. That means if customer want to be eligible for a discount, then he need to meet this minimum quantity. That is whatever we maintain here. Okay. And suppose next is from is nothing but it's a from quantity actually. It's a minimum quantity, it's from quantity. Like this specifies like what is the quantity from which system starts calculating free goods. That is okay. Next is units. Units is nothing but like say it can be what we call free. Same each cartons. Okay, it's a nothing but unit of measure, that kind of thing. And are free goods, that means if I order 100 and system calculates from this quantity and this many are free goods, suppose say 5 free goods. Okay, for example say order should be placed, minimum order quantity should be placed as 100 and system start calculating discount from quantity 30, and for every 30 quantity free goods is 5. That means for a order of 100 quantity, how many free goods customer will get? That again depends upon this calculation rule. Why? Because what to do with the other 10 quantity, right? In general it's 15. Why? Because it start calculating from 30, but there is another 10 quantity remaining. So what to do with that quantity, that is specified in this calculation rule. Okay, free good quantity and additional quantity is like for additional quantity what it to be done. So that's it. And see, in calculation we have three calculations, 1, 2, 3. That's pro rata, unit reference and whole units. Okay, say suppose I'll tell you by an example. First is pro rata, and these are very clearly mentioned here with the I'll explain you. Yeah. You're feeling sleepy? Okay. Oh my god, okay. Can you spare for 5 minutes or I'll just quickly wrap up. These are just controls which you can see there. So first one is pro rata. So pro rata says like say a system calculates free good in proportionate to the order quantity. That means just now we thought it is 15, right? But system will propose 15 point something for the 10. That means 10 divided by 3, and it can be some 3.33 something. So system will calculate some 3.33 like this. Okay, and we have one another option, unit reference. So unit reference system will say that it will consider only from as one unit. You see this from 30. That means it will offer free goods only for 30 30 30 3 30s. 10 it will not offer anything. Okay, that is unit, per unit. And next is whole unit. Next is come of whole unit. That is if order quantity is exactly divisible by the from quantity, that means this 100 should be divisible. Where it is? Yeah. The 100 should be exactly divisible. But is it divisible by 30, 100? No. But 120 can be divisible by 30? Yes. Like 4 times, right? So if it is only divisible by the from quantity, this is from quantity, then only the discount is eligible. You will not get anything here. You need to order 120 to eligible for a discount. Okay, so this specifies how the discount to be calculated, this calculation fields. Okay, and the next is free goods delivery. This field, all right, let me close this. I'll just quickly wrap up. Like free goods delivery control, that is this free goods one is, this free goods says that like whether the free goods is inclusive or exclusive. See, whenever you enter the system, you will be default in inclusive. You see, free goods inclusive. If you want to go, you need to click to exclusive. By default, you will be in inclusive. If you want to go to exclusive, then you need to click exclusive. And again, we have discussed in inclusive, we have item generation without item generation. Okay, so this takes care of that. Like whether it to be with item generation or without item generation. Okay, that's one thing. And next is delivery, free goods delivery control. See, this is a very interesting and important thing. Like this controls the free goods quantity should be delivered in proportionate to the main item quantity. That means it should be always proportional to the main item quantity. Okay, say suppose a small example, the quantity is 500. Order quantity is 500 and 100 is free goods. Okay, if I am delivering 250 quantity, then what should be the free goods quantity? It should be 50. Okay, so free goods should be always proportionate to the main quantity. Okay, so this controls that actually. Okay, so there are these things, that's it. And we already seen a gap in free goods that cannot be determined in the quotation, right? And one another scenario is there. I'll just quickly explain. Just give a thought and tell me tomorrow. Okay, see, I want free goods in return order. In standard order anyway I'll get free goods, but I want these free goods in return order. You know why? Yes, but returns is always with reference to return order, right? Okay. No, free returns is always with the return invoice actually. Okay, but in return invoice we will not get this free goods determined. It will show only the main quantity. That means what customer will do, he will order the quantity, he will keep the free goods with him and he will just return the main quantity. Right? So for this what we need to do is we need to create return order with reference to return order. In return order we can determine the free goods also. Okay, so this one interesting thing, when we create a return order with reference to order, like why? Because if we create invoice with reference to invoice as in a standard order process, system will not show free goods. Then system will lost, the company will lost this free good. You need to create a return order with reference to order. This has a sales order, right? Always return or return is with reference to invoice. But here we need to create with return sales order. Why? Because there is free goods also mentioned here. So that it will take the free goods also here. If not with this, it will show only main item, and the customer can keep up the free goods with him. Okay, this one simple scenario. So that's it with the free goods. You can find some questions here and some scenarios also, and all the configuration is mentioned here very clearly. Okay, you see all the questions is there here. VBN1, you see this VBN1, and the standard condition type is NA00. Free goods, anything, it starts with N. Yeah, you see this standard access sequence is NA00, standard condition type is NA00, standard pricing procedure is NA0001. Okay, with a just quick reading, you can get complete understanding of this free goods.
Okay.
So let us call it a day today.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay then. Bye bye.